This caravan park is very cool.
It's haunted.
No, the wildlife.
It's haunted.
No. Why? What did you? What happened to you? Did you get violated? The bird life here
is very, very friendly.
Very friendly. It's so cool because you get up, you have breakfast, you walk out and have your coffee, and there they are, just ready to share breakfast with you. It's like Giraffe Manor, but with rosellas.
Oh, one of the joys of van life is coffee in bed. But it is nice to wake up to a view.
Coffee and a pastry, some nice sun, and a diesel engine. What more do you want?
Good morning.
Good morning, Lily.
Oh, hi, guys. Time to breaks. No.
Birds' nests with the birds. You've got a big bird's nest on your head and you've got lots of birds around you.
Meow.
Shush.
This is not helpful.
It is.
Look, I got one of them out.
So we headed down to Port Arthur, which is the open air museum, historical site of old convict Tasmania. We'd been there before, but this time we went with our friends, the Coopers, and the girls were quite keen to experience
ghost life,
spooky, paranormal kind of thing. And we did.
Didn't they just?
Lily, it was just the clock.
Can we go now? I just really want to.
Where's Daddy?
I don't know, can we just go?
What's wrong, Daddy?
I just want to go home. Just
Oh, sweetie, it's nothing to be scared of.
Oh, no, I just want to go.
You're not feeling good about it?
No, I just want to go.
So what was the first thing that happened?
Lily went into the... They went into the a separate prison, which is where they kept everyone in effectively solitary confinement. And cell 11 in block A was a little bit creepy.
So Lily apparently walks up to the door. She was with you, wasn't she? And what did she do?
She stuck her head through the food slot and went, Daddy, I can hear something.
So then she came and got me, and I went down with her, and she's like, come and look, you know, I can hear something. I can't see anything, but I can hear something. Okay, come on, show me. What was in there?
I heard noises.
You heard noises in here?
Yeah, it was like a shell going or someone brushing their teeth. There's no one in there yet, but I could hear it on the other
side. And I put the camera lens sort of in there, and then I hear something that sort of sounds like crumpling paper or cellophane, and oh yeah, I got quite a fright.
Hi, today me and Mummy and some other people were hearing some sounds in one of the cells. Ooh, creepy. Not trying to creep you out. Well, and it's down one of these halls. Which do you think? It's number 11. Oh, I shouldn't have told you that.
11? Uh-huh. I need to finish my video.
Coming soon.
John said he heard something too. So it's definitely something up with cell 11.
Yes.
And that kind of
set you on edge.
Certainly did. But then, oh my gosh, we went to the Parson's house, which is
the Parsonage.
We went to the Parsonage, which is Australia's third most haunted house. And our experience there was a very, very grave one.
It moved people to tears.
And defibrillator stations. Oh my God. All right. So Russell and Lily needs a toilet break. So they go and I message Russell and I'm like, okay, so are we meeting you at this, you know, the haunted house? And Russell's like, oh, we're walking near the orchard. And
yeah.
And I just asked Russell now, was that like a decoy?
No, it wasn't. I was legitimately walking behind the orchard up to the parsonage.
Yep, so then what happened?
Well, we got there and Lily and I thought we could hear the other kids already playing in the house, so we thought we were going to get jumped out and attempted to be scared, which turns out it wasn't the other kids, it was some other random family.
Yeah, because all day the kids are like, oh, we're going to see a ghost, take a photo of this and that, you know, maybe we'll get a, you know, snapshot of a ghost. So then, what did you do?
So then, I walked in to the house thinking, oh, well, maybe they're inside, maybe we just haven't seen them yet. And then I found the deep, dark room and I hid in the corner.
So then we walk in, me and Olivia and the Coopers.
And I'm standing in there going...
And I thought at first, oh, it's just the audio, like, recording for some, you know, theatrical effects. And then it's kind of going when you can tell the recording part stopped. And then Olivia and I walk into the room, and I'd already scared her once, actually. I walked into the house and I was like, bah! And she's like, ah! Bah! And she's like, ah! Anyway, and so, and then I can see this red light flashing, but I think nothing of it. I just think, oh, it's just part of, you know, the electrics in the house and the once again, the theatrics.
In the church, when the clergyman can give a strong...
And I stepped around the corner.
You didn't even say boo.
I didn't say anything. I just stepped around the corner.
And I think the dead of Port Arthur heard these children scream. I took it in good stride.
You certainly did.
Which I usually wouldn't.
No, you normally would have lashed out and tried to hit me. Anna screamed. Olivia screamed. Chelsea screamed. And George bawled his eyes
out. Oh my God. Okay. So we had to share this story because it kind of adds to our whole experience, spooky experience at
Port Arthur.
So... after our day at the historic site, that evening, our friend John continued a tradition that he used to do when I was really little, where he used to read ghost stories. And he has a great way of bringing those stories to life with great animation. And he starts to read this story about a room in the parsonage, which is...
the third most haunted house in Tasmania.
Australia. And in the story, it talks about how various like people and tourists would go into the room and their cameras wouldn't work or their flashes wouldn't work, and back in the day would like rewind their film. And during the story, I say to him, I'm like, which room is, what house is that? And he says, the Parsonage. And then I start to tell him a story about earlier that day, Olivia and I were in one of the rooms of the Parsonage. And what happened?
Our flashes wouldn't work.
Yeah, so Olivia says to me, Mummy, how do I get my flash to work? And I say, well, you know, you, for the setting that your camera's on, you know, it will come up automatically like mine. Here, watch this. And I go to get my flash to activate and it won't do it. And I can't get the flash to flip up. I can't even take a photo. And I'm like, oh, okay, maybe it can't focus in on anything. But it wasn't that, like, I've taken photos in semi-dark before and I've never had a problem. And then Olivia tries to do it and she's like, it's not working. And I said, can you even take a picture? And she's like, no, it won't even take a picture. We just kept throwing a red light. And so...
It's never thrown a red light for me before. It hasn't.
It's never done. It's never...
No.
Wow. Never. Okay. So weird. So we couldn't take a photo. We couldn't get our flashes to work. And at the time, I thought nothing of it. But then when John was reading that particular story, I was like, that happened to both of our cameras, like at exactly the same time. And we couldn't get it to take a photo or activate the flash. And kind of all just sat there and we're like, that's really strange. So we had, yeah, a bit of a spooky day.
Mm-hmm.
You still scared?
No.
You tired?
Yeah.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree. We can rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. We safely walk to school without a sound.